We always required to change the orbit of satellite from circular to elliptical or elliptical to circular or hyperbolic, something like that. This is called a satellite maneuver. So here we are going to solve the same problem that we discussed earlier, in that it was orbiting in a elliptical orbit. Now we are going to change the orbit to a circular one by having a blast at perigee. Okay, so at perigee we are giving a certain small forces, some forces. With that forces, the orbit changes to a circular one. Okay, let us see how we can do this. So this is the figure. This is the Earth. This was the dotted line. This was the earlier orbit, elliptical orbit. So it have perigee and apogee. Now we want to change the orbit to a circular one. Okay, so that the radius of new orbit is same as the perigee radius, that is RP. Okay. Right, that is. So let us think how we can do that. Now let us transfer the satellite into a circular orbit at perigee. So we are transferring it at the perigee. So E and L be the initial energy and angular momentum, and E prime L prime be the new energy and angular momentum. Okay. So we have E is equal to minus C by A. Alright, in the last problem, A by RP is, A was 18 into 10 raised to 6, RP 7.5 into 10 raised to 6, and by cancelling you will get 12 by 5 divided by 15. On both numerator and denominator, you will get 12 by 5. Therefore, A is equal to 12 by 5 and RP. I am substituting here. A is 12 by 5 RP. Therefore, E is equal to minus 5 by 12 C by RP. Okay. RP is the radius at perigee and is the radius of new circular orbit. So we have E is equal to half m r dot square plus L square b 2 m r square minus C by R. Okay, that we learned earlier. So what happened at perigee? At perigee, there is no radial motion here. Therefore, r dot is 0. And R is equal to RP. Okay, so therefore, we have E is equal to L square by 2 me RP square minus C by RP. Okay. But E is actually minus 5 by 12 C by RP. Therefore, we have minus 5 by 12 C by RP is equal to L square by 2 me RP square minus C by RP. That is C by RP minus 5 by 12 C by RP is equal to L square by 2 mu RP square. From that, L square is 7 by 6 C M RP. Right? Okay, that is L square. From that, you can find L. So, this is the new orbit. RP is the radius. For the circular orbit, what is the major axis? Actually, it's diameter. Okay. So that is RP plus RP, that is 2RP. Okay, therefore new energy E prime is minus C by A, that is equal to minus C by A is 2RP, minus C by 2RP, that is the new energy. So the energy in the circular orbit. Also E prime is half m आर पी डॉट स्क्वयर प्लस एल प्राइम स्क्वयर बै टू मी आर पी स्क्वयर माइनस सी बै आर पी. सो इट इस सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग इन द अर्लियर इक्वेशन दैट इज ई इक्वल टू हाफ एम आर डॉट स्क्वयर प्लस एल स्क्वयर बै टू मी आर स्क्वयर टू एम आर स्क्वयर माइनस सी बै आर. हियर वी आर सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग आर एस आर पी एल एस एल प्राइम ई एस ई प्राइम फॉर ए सर्कुलर ऑर्बिट आर डॉट इज जीरो. ओके आर इज नॉट चेंजिंग देयरफॉर देयर इज नो रेडियल मोशन इन सर्कुलर ऑर्बिट देयरफॉर आर डॉट इज जीरो. देयरफॉर ई प्राइम इज इक्वल टू एल प्राइम स्क्वायर बाय टू मी आर पी स्क्वायर माइनस सी बाय आर पी फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन. हियर वी हैव ई प्राइम इज माइनस सी बाय टू आर पी इक्वेटिंग यूजिंग दीज टू इक्वेशन माइनस सी बाय टू आर पी इज इक्वल एल प्राइम स्क्वायर बाय टू मी आर पी स्क्वायर माइनस सी बाय आर पी. And taking this in left side, c by rp minus c by 2 rp is equal to l prime square by 2 mi rp square, or l prime square is equal to c m rp. Okay, from that you can find l prime. So what we have is e for the initial orbit, e is equal to minus 5 by 12 c by rp, and finally e prime is minus half c by rp, and l square is initial angular momentum, l square is 7 by 6 cm rp, and final l prime square is cm rp. What we can conclude is here, this is conclusion, e is greater than e prime, that is the initial value is larger than the final value, and l is greater than l prime. We can see from this equation. Okay, E is greater than E prime, L is greater than L prime because E is minus 5 by 12. So, it is greater than E prime. Okay, you can see the value. So, these are the conclusion. Now, we must give a thrust at perigee to change energy and angular momentum. Applying a braking thrust in the tangential direction, remember we are giving it in the tangent direction. If we are giving a braking thrust in the radial direction, it will change the energy but will not change the angular momentum. That's why we are giving it applying the braking thrust in the tangential direction. That will change the energy and angular momentum. Okay, so we are giving a braking thrust in the tangential direction at perigee. So at perigee, we know V is purely tangential, and the thrust will change the speed from V to a new value V prime. We call the new value as V prime, that's all. So we have from the energy equation E is equal to half mv square minus C by R. At perigee, we already calculated V square is 2 by M E plus C by RP. Okay, that is 2 by M E is the earlier value minus 5 by 12 c by rp plus c by rp, that is 7 by 6 c by m rp, and v prime is the final one. Here we are substituting 2 by m e as minus half c by rp plus c by rp, that is c by m rp. So that is initial velocity is v square is 7 by 6 c by m rp, and final one is c by m rp. So if you give the values and calculate, v is equal to square root of 7 by 6, c is 8 into 10 raised to 17, and m is 2 into 10 raised to 3 into rp is 7.5 into 10 raised to 6, you will get approximately 7900 as the value, and v prime you will get about 7300. So clearly the initial velocity is larger than the final velocity, so we are reducing the velocity. alright. So now let us check if the angular momentum has the required value to rotate in a circular orbit. That we have to check. So at perigee, V is perpendicular to R. So this is perigee. At perigee, V is perpendicular to R. Therefore, angular momentum is always R cross P. R and P is perpendicular means RP. That is M RP into V. So the initially it is MRP, initial velocity square root of 7 by 6 C by MRP. That is square root of 7 by 6 C MRP. Similarly, L prime, the final one, MRP V prime. That is MRP square root of C by V prime is square root of C by MRP. So this is square root of C by MRP. This is what we required. Okay. We already have the same value. That means this, the angular momentum is sufficient to get the velocity. So the maneuver can be executed by applying a braking thrust tangential to the orbit at perigee to reduce the speed of satellite from almost 7900 meter per second to 7300 meter per second. That is the conclusion. So maneuver is the changing process of orbit from one elliptical to circular or circular to elliptical, anyway.